We were seeing the decomposition reaction. As Muhammad Aman was saying, the decomposition is the splitting, the breaking down of a single reaction to form two or more products. From a single reactant, two or more products will be obtained. Such a reaction is called a decomposition reaction. We have seen two examples also. What happened to you? Say, all the day, I have to ask you to switch on the video. You make it a practice. Okay. You need not wait for the teacher to request to turn on your video. You must turn on. Okay. So we are seeing examples for decomposition reactions. One is the decomposition of lead nitrates. Lead nitrates. When lead nitrate is heated, lead nitrate decomposes, forming yellow-colored lead oxide, lead oxide yellow, brown nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen gas also. So there is a change in color. There is formation of yellow solid of a lead oxide, PbO, and the brown gas, nitrogen oxide, NO2. There is one more gas, and it is oxygen gas. It is colorless. It has no color. Another reaction we had seen, it was the decomposition of ferrosulfate. As you know, ferrosulfate is green in color. When green-colored ferrosulfate is heated, it decomposes, giving brown ferric oxide and sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide gases with the smell of burning sulfur. These gases have the smell of burning sulfur. There is pungent smell of burning sulfur. So these were the two reactions we had seen in the last day. Now let us proceed with the third reaction to show the decomposition reaction. And it is the decomposition of limestone, the third one, decomposition of limestone. When limestone is heated, it is decomposed. So on heating, you write the notes. I shall explain. You write first. On heating, comma, limestone. What is limestone? Limestone is calcium carbonate. Limestone or calcium carbonate, that is the chemical name for limestone. On heating, limestone or calcium carbonate decomposes. So it is a decomposition reaction. Decomposes. To form, what are the products obtained? To form white quicklime. What is quicklime? Calcium oxide, quicklime, and carbon dioxide gas. And the carbon dioxide. So these are the products of death. Carbon dioxide is a gas. So the third reaction is this. Limestone or calcium carbonate is heated. Then limestone or calcium carbonate decomposes. There is a decomposition reaction to form white colored quicklime, Q-U-I-C-K, quicklime or calcium oxide and carbon dioxide gas. These are the products of this. Let us write the equations for them, the reaction. Let us write the equations. You know, calcium carbonate or limestone, it is a CaCO3, and this is limestone. You write the equation. Limestone is calcium carbonate. Limestone, calcium carbonate. Formula of a limestone, CaCO3. Limestone is calcium carbonate. Then it is heated. You can show the reaction condition on the equation. The reaction condition is shown on the arrow, On the arrow, we are writing the reaction condition. What is the reaction condition? We are going to heat limestone. We are going to heat calcium carbonate, limestone. Then it decomposes, giving calcium oxide. And this is our quicklime. There is the formation of a quicklime calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So these are the products of things. Now you look at the side of the reactants. On the side of the reactant, there is only one reactant, calcium carbonate or limestone. There is only one reactant, namely limestone or calcium carbonate. Now you look at the side of the products. On the side of the products, there are two products. One is quicklime or calcium oxide. Quicklime or calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. So we get two products from one reactant. So one reactant is split. One reactant is split, that is decomposed, that is broken down. A single reactant, calcium carbonate, is breaking down to form two products, calcium oxide, quicklime, and carbon dioxide. And so the reaction is a decomposition reaction. Let us see the state conditions also. We can write the state conditions. To take quicklime, calcium carbonate, that is in the solid state, that is solid. Then limestone is a calcium carbonate solid. Quicklime calcium oxide, that is also solid. Carbon dioxide is a gas. And it's about the state conditions. Now if you try to balance the equation, you can see that the equation is already balanced. That is already a balanced equation. Balanced equation. Okay. Now let me ask you some small questions from here. What happens when limestone is heated? Vishnupriya, what will be your answer? What happens when limestone is heated? What is Vishnupriya's answer?
Calcium decomposes. White pick
cannot
climber.
See you. Okay, Emil, can you please help?
On heat,
what happens when limestone is heated?
It decomposes to form white quicklime, calcium oxide, and carbon dioxide.
Okay. When limestone is heated, what happens? Limestone decomposes with the formation of quicklime or calcium oxide, a white powder, and carbon dioxide gas. Okay. Carbon dioxide gas. That is what is happening there. When limestone or calcium carbonate is heated. Let me ask you another question. What is the type of reaction taking place when limestone is heated? What is the type of reaction, Nirubhama? What is the type of reaction taking place? When limestone is heated, what is the type of reaction? So it is there at the top. You look at the top, not on the ceiling of your house, your room. Now you look at the top of the notes. There can see what is the type of reaction. Nirubhama, what is the type of reaction? Okay, Aman, can you say what is the type of reaction taking place?
Decomposition reaction.
Okay, it is the decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction. Why is it called the decomposition reaction? Another question. Why is it called the decomposition? What will be our answer? Because a single reactant, limestone or calcium carbonate, splits, forming two products, namely quicklime or calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Okay. So that is a third example for the decomposition reaction. Here, let me give you some more points that is note regarding the decomposition reaction. That is for the test for carbon dioxide gas. The test for carbon dioxide gas. You know, carbon dioxide gas is a colorless, odorless gas. Colorless, there is no color. Odorless, there is no smell. O-D-O-U-R. O-D-O-U-R. Odorless, odor means smell. Odorless. Carbon dioxide is a colorless, odorless gas. But how can we test carbon dioxide gas? What's the test for carbon dioxide gas? It is a colorless, odorless gas which can extinguish fire. It can put out fire. It can prevent the fire. It can extinguish fire. It prevents fire. That is not the chemical test. The chemical test is this. When carbon dioxide gas is passed through clear lime water, I shall explain. Clear lime water, the lime water becomes milky. That is the first observation obtained. See, when carbon dioxide gas is passed through clear lime water, the lime water turns milky. It becomes white in color. It becomes white. There is turbidity. It becomes colored, white colored. So it turns milky. When excess carbon dioxide is passed, it becomes clear again. And that is the chemical test for carbon dioxide. So how can you test carbon dioxide? The physical tests are this. The physical tests, the physical tests are this. First of all, it is colorless. Second, it is odorless. It can extinguish fire. It can stop fire. It can prevent fire. It can put out fire. So a colorless, odorless gas which extinguishes fire, that is a physical test. And what is the chemical test? When carbon dioxide gas is passed through clear lime water, the lime water becomes milky. It turns turbid, white colored. An excess carbon dioxide is passed, it again becomes colorless, colorless. And what are the reasons for this? So here we can write the test for carbon dioxide. In a box you write, in a box, say, I will not repeat this test again. I will not take Amina, John, say, all of you, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So I will not take the test for carbon dioxide again. If I once teach you, it is taught forever. There is no question of repetition. I will repeat each and every reaction a number of times in the class, same class, but I will not repeat it again in the coming classes. No, I will not. So, what will be the test for carbon dioxide? You write in a box. Write in a box. Test for carbon dioxide. What is the test for carbon dioxide? You can write the test for carbon dioxide. You write. You can write the test. You write. Colorless. You write. Colorless, there is no color for carbon dioxide. Colorless, odorless, O-D-O-U-R, L-E-S-S. Colorless, odorless, odor means smell, means odorless, no smell. So colorless, odorless gas, so colorless, odorless gas, which extinguishes fire, which extinguishes, extinguish, G-U-I-S-H-E-S, extinguishes. Extinguish means to prevent, to stop, to put out, to stop. Extinguishes fire, and turns, that is the chemical test, turns clear lime water, milky. Clear lime water, milky. Milky means white color. Milky. That is the first observation. A colorless, odorless gas, which turns clear lime water milky. Lime water becomes white in color. Then, you return. How you return? Colorless, odorless gas, which extinguishes fire and turns clear lime water milky, white color, turbidity, milkiness, cloudiness, white color, that is milky color, turns milky, full stop. Then, if excess, more amount, if excess CO2 is passed, if we pass more amount of carbon dioxide, if excess CO2 is passed, excess CO2 is passed, the solution becomes clear. The solution becomes clear. Becomes clear. It becomes clear. C-L-E-K-R. C-L-E-K-R. It becomes clear. That is the test for carbon dioxide. You can write the chemical reaction behind the test. Test for carbon dioxide. Colorless, odorless gas, which extinguishes fire and turns clear lime water milky. First off, if excess EXCESS, if excess CO2 is passed, carbon dioxide is passed, excess means more amount. If excess carbon dioxide is passed, the solution becomes clear. The milkiness is gone. The milky solution becomes clear again. That is the test. Okay. That is the test for carbon dioxide. Now let us see what are the reactions taking place here. You should not close the box. You should not close the box. We are writing the test in a box, in a separate box. We are writing the test. You should not close it. I shall ask you to close the box. Okay. So the explanation part is over. Now we have to explain the test by means of chemical reaction. What are the chemical reactions taking place here? John Samuel, can you see this? Have you written this or not?
Yes, sir. Written? Yes.
See the test for carbon dioxide. Colorless, odorless gas, which extinguishes fire, it turns clear lime water milky. If excess carbon dioxide is passed, the solution becomes clear. It becomes clear. The cloudiness is gone. The milkiness is gone. The white color is gone. The turbidity is gone. And it becomes clear again. That is the test. And which are the reactions here. See, at this context, let me ask you another question. Another question. Come on. Another question. Say, who is going to give the answer? Say, Aman. Shakir, Aman. The question is to you. I'm asking you. Aman. Okay. The question is this.
Yes, sir.
Say, what is the test for hydrogen gas? Test for hydrogen gas. Come on. If you are not here, so what to do? Not audible.
Pop sound.
Okay. I shall repeat the test for hydrogen. What is the test for hydrogen? It's a colorless odorless gas which burns with a pop sound. Burns with a pop sound. That is the test for hydrogen. Colorless odorless gas which burns with a pop sound, P-O-P. P-O-P. Burns with a pop sound. Test for hydrogen. Now, another gas is coming, carbon dioxide. That is also colorless, odorless gas. But it will not burn. Say, hydrogen burns in air. It is combustible. It is combustible. It burns in air or oxygen. But here, carbon dioxide is not a combustible. It is not a supporter of combustion, but it is fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher. It stops fire. See, it prevents fire. Okay, test for carbon dioxide, repeat. Colorless, odorless gas, which extinguishes fire and turns clear lime water, milky. If excess CO2 is passed, the solution becomes clear again. That is the test. Now let us see the chemical reactions taking place here. Okay, which are the reactants here? Which are the reactants? Say carbon dioxide is gas is passed through lime water. Lime water. So the reactants are, which are the reactants? The reactants are lime water and carbon dioxide. Lime water and carbon dioxide. So these are lime water and carbon dioxide. So these are the reactants. Lime water and carbon dioxide. Let us see what is happening there. Okay. Let us take lime water. What is lime water? You continue. In the same box, you continue. You write lime water. That is L. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. You are right. You are going to pass carbon dioxide through clear lime water. So what is there in lime water? In lime water, there is calcium hydroxide. Lime water is a dilute solution of calcium hydroxide. And to calcium hydroxide, we are going to pass carbon dioxide. Then what happens? When carbon dioxide is passed, carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide. Carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide, forming a white solid precipitate, a white solid of calcium carbonate. Solid means insoluble, white insoluble, white colored, insoluble. Insoluble means it will not dissolve. So white insoluble calcium carbonate is formed. And so the solution becomes milky. So you're right. The reaction you continue. Say carbon dioxide reacts with or combines with calcium hydroxide. You're right. Carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide. My dear friends, am I too fast? Can you follow me?
Yes, sir.
Can you follow me, Adidev, Shankarji?
Yes, sir, we can follow you.
Are you too fast? No, okay. So carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide is present in lime water, that is lime water. So carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide, forming white, it is white colored, white insoluble means does not dissolve in water, white insoluble calcium carbonate, white insoluble calcium carbonate. Insoluble means it does not dissolve in water. It is not soluble. That is insoluble. Insoluble means not soluble. but not a dissolved one. Forming white insoluble calcium carbonate. It is white in color. It is insoluble in water. First of all. So, lime water becomes milky. Lime water becomes milky. Becomes milky. So, milkiness, the white color, turbidity, cloudiness is due to the formation of insoluble calcium carbonate, that is white in color. So white colored water insoluble calcium carbonate is formed. So lime water becomes milky. That is the first observation. Remember, when carbon dioxide is passed through clear lime water, it becomes milky. The milkiness, white color, turbidity, cloudiness is due to the formation of white colored insoluble calcium carbonate. And how is it formed? Carbon dioxide gas reacts with the calcium hydroxide. That is lime water. Carbon dioxide reacts with the calcium hydroxide, forming white insoluble calcium carbonate. That is why lime water becomes milky. Have you written this? This? Mr.
Yes, Nair, sir.
Aditya Nair. Written? Have you written the reaction? Have you written this or not?
Yes, sir.
Written? There is no response on your face. There is no response. So you're right. Ashi Patel raised hand. What's the problem, Ashi? Ashi, I cannot hear you. Very sorry. Cannot hear you. Can you write something so that I can see what you are writing there? Okay. So lime water becomes milky. Why? That is the question. When carbon dioxide is passed through lime water becomes milky. Why? That is the question. Why? What is your answer? John, Samuel, lime water becomes milky. Why? What is the reason? Lime water becomes milky. Why? Why is it?
Carbon,
why is it becoming milky? Okay, it becomes milky due to the formation of white insoluble calcium carbonate. Insoluble calcium carbonate. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കേൾക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ലേ? Okay. മക്കളെ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് പറയുന്ന കേൾക്കുന്നില്ലേ? നിങ്ങളിപ്പോ ഞാൻ കേൾക്കുന്നില്ലേ? എനിക്ക് സ്വല്പം പ്രോബ്ലം ഉണ്ട്.
ചില സമയത്ത്
ഞാൻ ഈ ബോർഡല്ല ഉപയോഗിച്ചിരുന്നത്. ആദ്യം സൈൻ തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്, ഞാൻ സമ്മതിച്ചു. നിങ്ങളൊക്കെ തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്, പക്ഷെ എനിക്ക് നിങ്ങൾ പറയുന്നത് കേൾക്കാൻ പറ്റാത്തതുകൊണ്ട് എനിക്ക് ഭയങ്കര ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടാണ്. എന്റെ ബോർഡ് മാറി, ഞാൻ ഈ ബോർഡിൽ എടുക്കാറില്ല. നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാം ഞാൻ ടെന്നിലാണ് എടുക്കാറ്. ഇന്ന് എനിക്ക് എന്ത് പ്രൊമോഷൻ തന്നിരിക്കുകയാണ്, നയനിലേക്ക്. അപ്പൊ ഒട്ടും കേൾക്കാൻ പറ്റണ്ട ഈ തുടങ്ങി. ഇതാണ് എന്റെ പ്രശ്നം. നിങ്ങൾ പറയുന്നത് എനിക്ക് കേട്ടാലാണ് എനിക്ക് ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ ചോദിച്ചിങ്ങനെ മുന്നോട്ട് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻസ് ചോദിക്കുന്നത്. നിങ്ങളെ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ടിക്കാനൊന്നുമല്ല, നിങ്ങൾ ഫോളോ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടോ ഇല്ലയോ എന്ന് എനിക്ക് അറിയാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടാണ്. നിങ്ങൾ ഫോളോ ചെയ്തില്ലെങ്കിൽ പിന്നെ ഞാൻ ക്ലാസ് എടുത്തിട്ട് എന്താ കാര്യം? ഇഫ് യു ആർ നോട്ട് നൗ യു റൈറ്റ് ദി ഇക്വേഷൻ. ദ ഇക്വേഷൻ you write the equation for this. OH twice calcium hydroxide. CA, you write the equation. Aditya, you write the equation. Adil, write the equation. Anchita, write the equation. CaOH twice, calcium hydroxide. Plus CO2, carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Then giving calcium carbonate. CaCO3. CaCO3. Calcium carbonate CaCO3. It is insoluble on a white. This is insoluble. That is insoluble in water. And it is white in color. That is a white in color. Insoluble. So insoluble white colored calcium carbonate is formed. That's why lime water turns milky. Calcium hydroxide and the calcium hydroxide is a that is lime water. Calcium hydroxide is a lime water. It is lime water. This is lime water. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide reacts with the carbon dioxide forming insoluble white colored calcium carbonate. Solid, isn't it? It is solid, insoluble calcium carbonate. Solid calcium carbonate is formed. Now, if excess carbon dioxide is passed, it becomes a clear again. Adam the carbon. Excess kadathi vidumbole endha vathiga you can write. What happens when excess carbon dioxide is passed? What happens? Right? When excess CO2 is passed. Excess CO2 is passed. You know that it becomes clear in the wonder. Why is it so? Why is it becoming clear again? Let us see. When excess EX spelling EX CESS excess more amount. When excess CO2 is passed, then it becomes clear. Why? From a soluble, that is soluble in water, soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate is formed. Hydrogen carbonate is formed. That is why it is becoming clear again. That is the second reaction, right? When excess carbon dioxide is passed, comma, soluble, it dissolves. Soluble, Mr. Nair, soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate is formed. It is soluble. Soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate is formed. When it becomes, say, milky, what happens? Milky, there will be the formation of an insoluble calcium carbonate. See the difference? Milky. So it becomes milky. Why? Insoluble calcium carbonate is formed. So it becomes milky. Now, it becomes clear. Why? Because water soluble, S-O-L-U-B-L-E, soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate is formed. That is why it is becoming clear. So the solution becomes clear. Solution becomes clear. That is due to the formation of soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate. turbidity, milkiness, cloudiness due to insoluble calcium carbonate. Clear due to the formation of soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate. Hydrogen carbonate. Return. Aditya, Naya. Return.
Yes, sir.
Oh, there is no sign on your face. You must show some sign. Have you written this or not?
Yes, sir.
Just show your hand. Raise your hand at least. Okay. Now, we can write the equation for the second reaction. We can write the equation for the second reaction. Second reaction equation is this one. Ah, here I forgot to give you one more thing. See, please. You have to make a correction here. Plus H2O. I forgot to write that. You're right. I made the correction in the equation. Sorry, very sorry. I just now I noticed it. In the former equation. Just in the former equation, CaOH twice plus CO2 giving CaCO3 plus H2. Water is there. Calcium carbonate is insoluble in water. Insoluble in water. Now water is also there. Please make the correction. Please make the correction of the equation. Correct the equation, please. Now you can get the second reaction. Second reaction is this. CaCO3 plus H2O plus excess CO2 giving CaHCO3 twice. CaHCO3 twice. See the bracket. CaHCO3 twice. HCO3 is hydrogen carbonate. If it is CO3 carbonate, HCO3 hydrogen carbonate, then calcium hydrogen carbonate, CaHCO3 twice. See the bracket, HCO3 within the bracket. HCO3 is hydrogen carbonate. So HCO3 within the bracket. HCO3 twice. See, you should be very careful when writing the chemical equations. You cannot simply write 2, 3, etc. here and there. It is very meaningful. So HCO3 twice. HCO3 should be within the bracket. Hydrogen carbonate, HCO3 should be within the bracket. Please don't make the mistake. Calcium hydrogen carbonate, this is a soluble. SOLUBLE, soluble. You just look at the first equation, compare both equations. CaCO3, insoluble. It does not dissolve. While HCO3 twice, calcium, hydrogen carbonate, soluble. See the difference? CaCO3, insoluble. While HCO3 twice, soluble. Got it? Ross, Nirupama, Adi, Adil, follow these things. CaCO3, insoluble. It is white in color. While HCO3 twice, soluble. Soluble in water. It dissolves in water. That's why it is getting clear. Again, when excess CO2 is passed. Now you can close the box. You can close the box. We were discussing the test for a carbon dioxide. Discussing the test for a carbon dioxide. Close the box. So many things are there. So many things are there. First, test for carbon dioxide. Remember, colorless, odorless gas extinguishes fire and turns clear lime water milky. When excess CO2 is passed, it becomes clear again. And what's the reason? Reason is here. Lime water is calcium hydroxide. CO2 reacts with the calcium hydroxide, forming white colored insoluble calcium carbonate. And so it becomes milky. The equation CaOH twice, like water. First CO2 giving CaCO3, that is calcium carbonate, white in color, insoluble. Plus H2, when excess CO2 is passed, it becomes clear. Why? Because calcium carbonate plus H2O plus CO2 excess giving CaHCO3 twice, calcium hydrogen carbonate, that is soluble. That is a soluble. So that is the test for a carbon dioxide. And this reaction will not be taken again. Nobody will take this again. Okay. So we were talking about the decomposition reaction. And from the decomposition reaction, we have twisted to the test for carbon dioxide. So what is lime water? Aditya Nair, what will be your answer? What is calcium? What is lime water?
Calcium carbonate.
Calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide. Lime water. And what is the test for carbon dioxide? Anne-Marie?
When
excess CO2 is passed, it becomes a clear again. And what is the reason? Carbon dioxide reacts with calcium hydroxide, forming insoluble calcium carbonate. So it becomes milky. When excess CO2 is passed, water soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate is formed. CaHCO3 twice. Okay, it is soluble in.